Healthcare workers are often instructed to wash their hands to prevent the spread of drug-resistant infections between patients. But a new study suggests that targeting an additional population for hand washing may help, and that is the patients themselves. Welcome to Microbial Minutes. This is ASM's update on what's hot in the microbial sciences, the Whose Hands Need Washing edition. I'm Julie Wolf, and we'll be highlighting a story from Clinical Infectious Diseases, which shows that patients can be a source of multi-drug bacteria in hospitals. So multi-drug resistant organisms are especially a large problem in healthcare facilities where a single patient who is colonized can have that isolate spread to other patients by healthcare workers who do not properly wash their hands or remove gloves. And this is particularly dangerous because there are many immunosuppressed or vulnerable patients who may have underlying conditions making them more susceptible to infection. Now, there have been lots of different hand-washing campaigns that have been aimed at care workers to make sure that they not only have access to soap and water or under tight timelines, maybe an ethanol-based hand rub, but that they rub their hands for the appropriate amount of time to mechanically remove all those bacteria that they may have accidentally picked up. And this is these campaigns have been run with the purpose of preventing nosocomial or hospital-acquired infections. But there are drug-resistant organisms and multi-drug-resistant organisms that live within the community and can be passed between individuals at the shopping market or the mall or the playground. Really, there's not any place that could be considered completely free of these, and patients may bring these in with them when they're admitted to the hospital. Of course, once patients are in the hospital, they begin to touch different surfaces, such as doorknobs, which is completely natural, but this may contribute to some of the multi-drug resistant organisms being seen within the hospital. And so what this group wanted to ask is what contribution of these resistant organisms comes from patients? And so on the next slide, we'll see that the researchers, it was some physician scientists, set up a surveillance study over around 6 months in 2017, taking place in two different hospitals in southeastern Michigan. Around 400 patients participated in this survey, in which they were admitted to the hospital and their history of multi-drug resistant organism presence was taken. Of course, they would mostly be assessed for things that had caused disease. Any carriage within the last 3 months was not very easy to assess. But they would also have their bodily fluids screened. That would be things like urine, sputum, blood, and any wound cultures would be assessed for antibiotic susceptibility. And they would, researchers would also note any antibiotic use by these patients, device uses, as certain indwelling devices can make a patient more give a propensity for infection, and the presence of any wounds upon admittance. They also did some microbiological swabbing, so they would swab the palm and the fingers of the patients as their nail beds to assess for the presence of these different bacteria, and they also swabbed the nares or the nasal cavity of these patients, trying to assess different niches within the same patient. In addition to swabbing the patients, they swabbed the hospital rooms in which the patients were staying. And so they looked at different high touch surfaces, things that people have a propensity to touch, things like the bed rail or the call button, the bedside tray table, the phone, the toilet seat, and of course, the bathroom doorknob. We are always opening and closing things and touching the doorknobs. And they would first swab those surfaces within 24 hours of a patient's admittance. Then they would repeat at 3 days and 7 days, and then weekly after the first week had gone by. In the upper right hand on the in that graph with the green, blue, and yellow, we're looking at the percentage of patient hand contamination and room surface contamination with these multi-drug resistant organisms. You can see that 10% of patients, when admitted, had multi-drug resistant organisms on their hands at the time of admittance, and that 6.2% of these patients acquired one of these multi-drug resistant organisms, or MDROs, within the following check, so quickly acquiring additional resistance organisms. in the bottom, you can see the time, the effect of time in which there was a stepwise increase in colonization of both the patients and the patient room surfaces that increased with the number of hours a patient was staying within that room. This makes intuitive sense, but is not something that has really been very carefully studied previously. And as we'll see in the next page, this was written up in a couple of technical outlets, largely because it has a big implication for infection control within hospitals and healthcare facilities. So Medical Express published what was more or less the press release from the research group, in which the first author, Lona Modi, was quoted as saying, "We are all in this together, no matter where you are, in a healthcare environment or not, this study is a good reminder to clean your hands often using good techniques, especially before and after preparing food, before eating food, after using a toilet, and before and after caring for someone who is sick to protect yourself and others." Modi has a large interest in healthcare and infection control and has gone on to present at a study at a conference, a study that is not yet published but was written up in Tech Times, showing that one of the most commonly contaminated surfaces was the curtains that can separate patients that hang between different beds, because those handles are commonly moved in order to move the curtain back and forth. As a reminder, we've included a link to the CDC's hand washing page. They have a number of different hand washing sites, but one of them gives instructions on the best way to remove any potential microorganisms that are not a normal part of your skin microbiome. That includes not only washing and lathering your hands, but making sure that you scrub them for a full 20 seconds. If you don't feel like counting, you can always hum happy birthday twice under your breath. And we'll add a link to that down below if you want to see any more about proper hand washing techniques. So in this clinical infectious diseases study, that patients carrying drug-resistant microorganisms may present a new target for infection control. I'd like to thank you for listening and thank Ray Ortega for production. I'm Julie Wolf, and I'll be with you next time on Microbial Minutes.